last lesson, you saw that NumPy arrays have a dtype, which is the type of each element in the array. For example, the dtype of this array is int64. int64 means a 64-bit integer. Now, this also applies to two-dimensional arrays. Each element in the array is expected to have the same type. This can make it inconvenient to use two-dimensional NumPy arrays to represent the contents of a CSV file. For example, suppose I tried to create a NumPy array to represent the student enrollment data from Lesson 1. I've recreated a small piece of that data here. Even though when I created the array, I entered integers and booleans without quotes, each element has been converted to a string. The dtype is also S14, meaning strings of length at most 14. Obviously, it doesn't make sense to take the mean of strings, such as canceled, but it would make sense to take the mean of just the days to cancel column. The days to cancel column is column 3, so I can access it like this. However, if I take the mean of this column, then it doesn't work. Instead, NumPy says that it cannot perform the reduce with a flexible type, which means that it doesn't know how to take the mean when not all of the values are numbers. That's one benefit of Pandas data frames over two-dimensional NumPy arrays. A data frame is also a two-dimensional data structure, but each column is assumed to be a different type. Another benefit is that data frames have indexes similar to Pandas series. There is an index value for each row and a name for each column. So instead, I'll create a Pandas data frame from this data. I can do that by passing in a dictionary mapping column names to lists of values for that column. So one key in the dictionary would be account key, and the list would be all of the values for the account key column. And similarly for the other columns. Now when I take a look at the data frame, it's displayed in a nice table. The column names are at the top, and the row indexes are integers starting at 0. There are some other ways to create Pandas data frames as well, which you'll take a look at soon. Now if I take the mean of the data frame, it takes the mean of each numerical column and ignores the others. IsUdacity is a numerical column here with trues treated as 1 and falses treated as 0. You'll notice that Pandas did not take the mean of the entire data frame here, but of each column. Since each column is assumed to be a different type, this makes more sense for Pandas. You can also use the axis argument to take the mean of each row instead, although that won't work in this case since each row contains some non-numerical data.